Smile at BBTV. We're over at Arnie's Gym in Failsworth. I'm pleased to say I'm joined by former world title challenger Jimmy Kelly Jr. How are you, mate?
Good, mate. How are you? You all right?
Yeah, good. Good to see you. I was hoping to bump into you, have a catch up, Jim, see where you're up to with stuff, really.
Yeah, nice to see you. Obviously, I'm obviously Aki popping around, but obviously, it's nice difference. See, you know, you look like you lost a bit of weight and stuff like that.
Yeah, I have actually.
Yeah, you look well, mate, you look really well. Yeah. You're dyeing your hair as well.
Don't know about that, but you don't look too bad yourself.
I have mine tattooed on.
So yeah, fight-wise, I just asked you then, you said you're open to, you've got something lined up.
Yeah.
I was looking then at your record, it's 2019 you was last in there.
Yeah.
2018 before that, which was the one in Australia.
Mm.
So it's been... it's been a bit of up and down in the last few years. Obviously, we've had this this other year off as well. So it's been a while since you've been in the ring, Jim.
Yeah, so I've just got, I'm on the 9th of October, Gary Booth show at the AJ Bell Stadium. I think it's just dipping my toes back in. And yeah, like I said, the last few years, I had so many fights early in my career, and like within like the first 6-7 years, I had like 20-odd fights, 25 fights. So, you know, it's been a bit of a shame that I've not been as active. But you know, you got to take the rough with the smooth, and you know, I see the positives of it. I've been able to, I've not been going through grueling training camps back after back, and you know, I've been in the gym, but I've just been consistent and ticking over, and able to improve and work on. And you know, I think ultimately, I said it before, I think like the little bit of inactivity has served me well, and it'll something that'll add like years onto my career. You know, I don't think anyone has been as consistent as me in the country, like through the time. Like I've kept fit. I still spar all the time. I've say like last year we were doing marathons every other week, and you know, I'm always in shape. So, and yeah, I'm looking forward to it. And it's a bit of a bug with the pandemic, but again, I just kept ready and I kept myself motivated and I kept my belief strong. And you know, I'm taking the first steps now, and you know, a couple of fights back to back. 40 years out, and then we'll have a sit down over the new year and have a proper look and see what's knocking about.
You said Gary Booth's got a couple of shows on. What any dates and what sort of fights are you looking?
I think the first one is it's about 6 weeks away. I think it's October the 9th at the AJ Bell Stadium. I just think, you know, I've left it to Gary. I wanted a six, so we've been able to get like a six rounder on that. Regarding the opponents again, like it probably just I get back into it, get the juices flowing a little bit, and you know, I'm airing a show in like late November, early December. So again, we'll take a little bit of a step up for that, and then you know, hopefully I can eight or something, and we'll just see what's happening in the new year. You know, we'll go into new year obviously two back to back if everything, you know, holds, you know, as it's looking like it's opening and stuff like that. So. You know, we're hopeful for that as well. We're determined by that, but yeah, mate, I'm looking forward to it.
I go back a bit with Jim. How old are you now?
29 next week, aren't I?
29.
Yeah, 29 next week.
I mean, I remember from a kid at Jimmy Egan's that, but when, you know, when you've turned pro and you was at Champs Camp with Ensley and Morris, we were doing interviews then, and so
pro 10 years next year. So. You know,
you're 29. You know, you got a lot of experience behind you, and like I said, you're not been in too many hard fights, so the best years ahead of you.
Yeah, I fully believe it, and I know a lot of people can look at age, but you know, I look at that, the miles on your clock. Like I really do like look after myself. You know, I've never drank. I've always been in the gym. You know, I'm from a kid. Like if I've not been boxing, I've been wrestling. And you know, last year when I toned down like the work of my boxing, and I'd done like a lot of strength and conditioning, and I was doing like good marathons like every other month. I'd done like 6-7 last year, and I was getting like quite good times, like under 3.5 hours and that. And you know, that was just really just going out and just not really training towards it. So I do fully believe that there's a lot of miles left on my clock, and you know, I'm sparring like young guys and all the time, and my experience is showing. Like I had good sparring yesterday, and I've got some like rest of the week with Aaron McKenna, you know, an Irish kid who was based in America. He's come over, you know, we got a good 8 rounds yesterday, and I just think, you know, where I was young and like aggressive and explosive and that, like I've also like see like a Bernard Hopkins style where I've been able to try like be more box as well, you know what I mean, like box a little bit more and just use my experience and that, and I think it's working well for me, and you know, all this will show on the 9th.
I mean, getting fights at the moment is a priority, and just getting back in there, isn't it? But you know, realistically, yeah. What is sort of an aim for you over the next couple of years? Have you got a direction you want to go in, and what do you feel you can achieve?
I think I can still achieve like a world title, and you know, when I look at what's about, I like that Eubank fight at middleweight. I think he's a different animal to super middle, obviously, when he beat James Gale and Yildirim and the likes of those fighters, but I don't think he's quite the same fighter in middleweight. You know, maybe that he's a big guy, maybe the weight cut hurts him and he hasn't got that explosiveness or that work rate anymore at that weight. And you know, I can relate, like when he used to make 154, it was, you know, I wasn't the same fighter, and I had a lot of knockouts early in my career, but as I used to drain to that weight, I didn't have the gears to go through. But you know, like that's just a personal goal in my mind. You know, it's not going to be a conversation that can be had for, you know, 6-8 months. He's obviously in the position he's in, and it's for me to get these couple of wins and get myself in a position. But yeah, I think that could be a good fight for us.
Mm. Chris Eubank Jr. Well, Marcus Morrison fought him not long ago. Another Manchester lad, didn't he? So.
Yeah,
and,
no.
Yeah, I don't see why not. It's a fight that could be made.
Yeah, of course. I think
get a few wins. Yeah, a couple of wins on your belt.
Yeah, I think it want to make sense, but again, like it's down to me to do my thing. You know what I mean, I'm not in a position to have that fight yet. But you know, like if I do the right things, and I believe I will do, like that's a fight that's there. But you know, everything else will fall into place.
You're with Arnie, Anthony Farnell, now over here. It's been a while now you've been with Arnie, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, do you know what? And it's been good. Like, a lot of times you move to training, you've got like the training camp and fight, but you know, we've gelled and you know, we've added like a lot of stuff to my game, and you know, I think that you're going to see, like, I see it's like chapter 3, or like this is my third training, it's chapter 3 in my career, and it's the last chapter, like me with Arnie, and you know, I've got my manager James, who's like fully behind us. He's going through a few health things and that, but you know, everything, like I think that finally everything's fell into place. Yeah. And I'm looking forward to it. I think even life, like, you know, I've got a happy home, my kids are doing well, everything just seems to be aligned at the minute. So I'm really grateful.
Yeah, everything. Yeah, in a good place to do this third move, as you say, of your career there.
I'm looking forward to it.
You said you've added things to your game. I mean, you do as you go on, don't you, as a pro and all that, but what is it, while you've been here with Arnie, what is it that you've added to your game?
Just like more defensive, keeping calm in like certain situations. Like, you know, when I was young, I was like aggressive and high work rate. You know, then when I left Champs Camp, I trained with Lee Baird, and you know, Lee's a good trainer. And obviously he's quite like defensive and stuff like that, so I think I had one extreme to the other, but I think like with Arnie, like I found the middle, you know what I mean? I'm excited and confident that it's going to be a good part of my career.
Well, mate, I definitely look forward to seeing you back in there, no doubt about it. I'll get down for that one, but it's good to catch up with you, mate. I just wanted to see where he was up to, and it's nice to see you again.
Yeah, buzzing, mate. Yeah, mate,
good that you got some news.
Yeah, I said I've just kept like I've kept strong and all the way through. Like even if, because it's not like I've not had fights. Like, you know, it was early 2019. I was supposed to fight Rob Brandt in Atlantic City, but that fell through. And then you know it was COVID hit then, and that just put us out. But you know, like you turn up to the gym, and I don't just train for like a training camp. You know, I come to the gym like, you know, week in week out, just as like you get up in the morning, brush your teeth, or you have a shower. That's just part of your routine. That's what you do, and that's exactly. Huh? Yeah, you went ages ago. Sorry, Arnie. So yeah, and I've just stayed in the gym, and you know, no matter what, even the days when I've been tired or there's no news like on the horizon, like, I've just always been in the gym and practicing, and you know, credit to Arnie for being there and not being frustrated that he's putting his time and effort into us all the time, and nothing's there. And you know, my manager, fair play to James, like, you know, and he's got a bit of a health thing going on as well. He just found out he's got cancer, but you know, he's really positive in that, and you know, I've got a lot of people that have believed in me, and I've got to give back to them. You know, my missus is, because she's like, look at me, thinking, where's my mansion?
So I've got to. I don't know if I should turn it or not.
Go say hello. So yeah,
Mrs. Kelly. Then.
So yeah, you know, she's been supportive. You know, she's known that I've had my dream, and you know, she's been supportive, and she looks after the kids when the kids, you know, all the night feeds, and I've always used boxing as an excuse why I can't do the night feeds. So yeah, I'm just happy, mate. Like I said, you can't be like a happy fighter, and I'm happy, and I'm just looking forward to. I'm excited just to go through the whole fight routine and get in good shape and like proper shape, like fight shape, and have fight night and enjoy, and hopefully my son, he'll be five then, hopefully he might come and watch, and it might be a memory that he keeps, like your memory from being a four-year-old watching TV.
Yeah. It's great to hear, Jimmy, everything's going well, and like I say, look forward to seeing you back out soon.
Cheers, mate, thanks
good
so
to catch
much.
Up with you, mate.